Merry Christmas. What a gift to be together on this most sacred, very special night. And it is just wonderful to look out and see all of you here. I am thankful for each of you and for your presence here in this place. And I look forward to spending this time of worship together. I thought I'd begin with a gift that I was given as I walked in the door here just a few moments ago. I have been given a handmade Christmas card from Miss Sophia Hathaway. Sophia, are you in here? She may be down. Oh, she is. Yeah, she's up in the top. She's at the very top. She gave a Christmas card to me, and I just love it. It says, Merry Christmas. It has three crosses on it. And on the inside, it says, May the Lord be with you. I hope you have a very Merry Christmas. And so that is our wish as we begin tonight. We have Jesus, God, and a snowman. And so we'll hang on to that as we begin. Sophia, thank you for sharing that with us. As we begin our time of worship together, I would invite you to stand as you're able and let us sing with glad hearts, hymn number 240, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Let's sing together. You may be seated. At this time, the Harrison family will come and help us in the lighting of our Advent wreath. And I would invite you to remember, as we have throughout this Advent season, we'll sing with the choir before they begin the readings and the prayers, and we'll sing again as a part of the Advent lighting time. Thank you.
Source, the ending. conclude our Advent journey as we light the Christ candle, welcoming the one promised in Scripture. He is called Emmanuel, God with us. We celebrate the hope brought to earth by our wonderful counselor.
He is called Emmanuel, God with us.
We rejoice in the strength and power of a mighty God.
He is called Emmanuel, God with us.
We sing of peace on earth and goodwill to all people.
He is called Emmanuel, God with us.
And we lift our hearts in praise to our everlasting Father.
He is called Emmanuel, God with us. Joy to the world, the Lord has come.
Tonight we light all the candles as we celebrate the birth of Christ, the wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. As the light from these candles fills the room, we light the Christ candle, welcoming the newborn King, the one who is Emmanuel, Jesus Christ, God with us. Gracious Lord, throughout this Advent season, we have come to know you by many names. Tonight we celebrate your birth and thank you for being our wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Remind us that no matter where we are or where we've been, you are with us. We gather in the glory of this night to welcome you as Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. We pray this in the wonderful name of Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Hallelujah. shepherds as they say, burning brightly, led wise men and kings. Hallelujah. There they fell prostrate and worshiped at his feet. Flooded by God's presence, they meet. Jesus, one big family, and still the earth sings praises of his birth as heaven kissed
You'll join with me in prayer. On this night, God, we say hallelujah. We say thank you for doing such a magnificent, wonderful, and mysterious thing those many years ago when you came to earth as an infant, as a baby, giving us this gift, our salvation, in the form of a small child. Thank you, God, for this magnificent gift. No gift could ever be greater. Help us to go forward and give this gift to others, not just at this time, but every day. Give us hope. Give us peace. Fill us with joy and love as we celebrate the birth of our Savior. And it's in his name we pray. Amen. If you'll stand as you are able and join with us as we sing our hymn of anticipation, number 230, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Oh,
You may be seated, and any other children that we have that might like to come down for our children's moment, please come on down. Thank you.
Well, good evening. Are you guys excited? It's Christmas.
Yeah.
I have a couple of questions for you guys. Come on up. She's so adorable. Yes. I'm ready, too. It's Christmas. I have a few questions for you guys. When you think of a king, what does that king look like? Johnny. A crown? Yeah? Yeah.
He rules the kingdom?
Rules over a kingdom, yeah. What else? When you think of a king, what does he look like? Yeah. Sophia. Powerful, mighty. Yeah. Yeah. So when you think of God, what do you think God looks like, or what do you think about God?
I think he looks like someone that saves us.
Someone who saves us. Yes. Very good answer. Yes, Eva.
I think he takes care of the
shepherds and the sheep. Yes. Yes. So when you think of a baby, what do you think about? Yeah.
I think a baby looks cute.
Yes, a baby is cute. Yes. Babies are very cute. Good answer. What else? What do you think of a baby? What do you think about a baby? Yes. They're tiny. Yes. Yeah. They're small. Yeah.
And they're so chubby.
They're chubby. Oh, I love it. You could just peach their cheeks, tickle their bellies, their toes, tiny fingers. That's a good answer. So, when you think of Jesus, yes.
He's a cool man.
He's a cool man. Yeah. Well, do you know that baby Jesus is our king? And our God? Yeah.
And Jesus is God's son.
That's right. Yes. So we have baby Jesus, God's son. God sent his son as a little tiny baby. Yeah.
Jesus and God, they both watch over us.
They watch over us, yes. And it's pretty interesting to think of a little baby as our king and our God, isn't it? It's pretty amazing. It's pretty marvelous. Yeah.
And also, they do have beards.
And they have beards. Yes. God. Yeah, God has a beard, probably. I can see that. Kings, yeah. Yeah. Jesus may have had a beard when he was older. A short one. He was Jewish. Okay. Yes. But that's interesting, just to think of Jesus being our king and our God, mighty, strong, wonderful Savior, a shepherd. He also watches over the shepherds, and he was a little tiny baby. And that's what we celebrate tonight, Jesus coming as a little baby. We have a gift for you guys. So we're going to take this time, and I'm going to give you guys this little book, and I want you to take this book, and I want you to read it tonight. Get your parents to read it with you. And you can read it to your other siblings if you have them. But it is about how Christ came as a little tiny baby. Watch out for your cards. And there is a card, little card in there. You can have one, Doug. All right, let's pray. Dear God, thank you for coming to save us. And thank you for coming to save us even as a little tiny baby who grew up to be such a big, strong man who took on our salvation. Help us always to think about you and to love you. And it's in the name of our King, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Merry Christmas. Thank you.
I would invite you, as you are able, to stand and let us affirm our faith together with those ancient words of the Apostles' Creed. Let us affirm our faith together. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, Our gospel lesson tonight, of course, comes from the second chapter of Luke's gospel, the first through the 20th verses. Will you pray with me? Oh Lord, we thank you for your presence here in this place. We thank you that you move among us and that you have come to receive our worship, to enliven our worship, to lift our hearts, and to fill us with your joy and your Holy Spirit. We turn again to words that we've read so many times, to this story that somehow never gets old, no matter how many times we tell it or hear it. We thank you and we praise you that we get to read it again tonight and that we get to hear from you. We pray that your Holy Spirit would be poured out afresh in this moment and that we might be filled with your word, that this story that is our story might be written on our hearts forever. We trust that you will do that, for you are faithful. We pray this in the name of your Son, Jesus, and we love you with all our hearts. We say together, Amen. Let us hear the word of God. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for him in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known all that had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured these things, all these words, and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. I've often wondered, why shepherds, why would God send an angel to shepherds? My goodness, they were the lowest of the low. I'm just telling you how it was. They were just the lowest of the low, stinky, smelly shepherds who spent 90% of their time with sheep or other animals. They were just low people. They were even less important than Mary and Joseph. If you can imagine getting any less important than a poor carpenter and an unwed 13-year-old mother having a baby in a feeding trough. That's just who they were, shepherds. Just wonder, really, shepherds? No, nobody is going to listen to anything that these shepherds have to say. Nobody's going to pay any attention to what the shepherds tell them about this baby. They're shepherds. Nobody cares what they say, what they think, what they do. And yet, it is to shepherds that came good news of great joy for all the people. Unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. The shepherds heard it first. It is the only time in the whole New Testament that Jesus is given that magnificent title, Christ the Lord. And it is the shepherds, who get to hear it, who get to carry it in their hearts, who get to hold it and give it to the world. It comes from the shepherds. This Jesus in the manger is God's gift to the whole world. It is God's anointed one. Filled with power and righteousness, the full presence and love of God turned loose on the world. And he comes as a baby. So tender, so dependent, so vulnerable. As Kian said, so chubby. He comes as a baby, born in a place that is so crowded that they had to lay him in a feed trough. That's what a manger is. Here is God's gift to the world, wrapped up in the messy, crumpled brown paper of ordinary life. Christmas makes us think about gifts, doesn't it? How many of us have spent the last 2, maybe 3 months just stewing over gifts? How many gifts do I need to buy this year? Do I have enough money to buy all of those gifts? Have I gotten this person enough presents? Is it right? Have I done right? Are they going to get me a gift and me not have them a gift? Do I still have time tonight to order from Amazon and have it here tomorrow? If I'm an Amazon Prime member, maybe. Maybe they can get it to me. I don't know. One of those drones might could drop it on my front porch. Gift giving. My goodness, it can certainly get out of hand. But it is a sacred tradition, especially for we who follow Jesus. It is a sacred tradition that reminds us of God's gift given to us in Jesus. It makes us think of the best gifts we've ever been given, doesn't it? You think of the best Christmas gift that you have ever received. Just take a moment and think about the best gift you've ever received. I think of mine. It was about Easter of 1986. I started asking really early for something so special that I knew Santa would have a hard time getting it for me. So I had to start early. I was really into He-Man at the time, okay? Anybody else ever into He-Man? Did you know? You knew, some of y'all know He-Man, yeah. Well, I loved He-Man. I would watch He-Man every morning before school. I had a He-Man book on tape that we could take in the car with us. And listen, that's before you had a DVD or a VCR in your car. You had a book on tape? I had that. I had just a few action figures, and I also had a He-Man sword that I had made myself from a wrapping paper tube. Okay? It worked. It did the trick. But what I did not have, a He-Man battle cycle. Okay? This is the real deal. I did not have that. And I wanted that thing so badly. That's what I wanted. I lobbied for that thing for half a year, which when you're 5 or 6 years old, that is an eternity to remember that you want something that bad. I thought about it all the time. I left pictures of it in the house. I had to have that He-Man battle cycle. I hoped for it. I dreamed about it. I talked about it all the time. Life would be just perfect if I could just get a He-Man battle cycle. What I did not know was how very tight things were for my family in 1986 and for many years after that, too. I didn't know. I didn't have any idea that $89.99 for a dressed-up bicycle was more than my parents could handle. I didn't know that. I didn't understand that they had scrimped and saved and done without all year long just so we could have a few presents under the tree and a nice dinner on Christmas Day. I didn't know any of that. And so I wasn't quite prepared to appreciate the Christmas miracle that came on Christmas Day. My brother and I, my little brother and I waited anxiously at the end of the hall until Mama told us that we could go in, that it was okay to go into the living room where Santa Claus had been. It was 5:30 in the morning on Christmas Day, and we were deeply troubled by the late start we had had already. But it was okay. It was okay because we rounded that corner into the living room, and I saw just behind the smaller packages, I saw something tall behind the smaller packages that had the socks and the shirts and the underwear that's always there. I saw a bicycle. And I looked a little closer, and I saw a He-Man symbol on it. My goodness, Santa Claus had come through. I was just astounded. I was amazed. I had actually gotten a He-Man battle cycle for Christmas. I hugged my parents. I even kissed my little brother on the forehead before I jumped on that thing and rode it into the kitchen and had the best time of my life. Good news of great joy filled my heart. I was so glad until I looked a little closer. And I realized it was not a He-Man battle cycle. They couldn't afford a He-Man battle cycle. Instead, my daddy had found some old broken-down bike in a dumpster somewhere in town. And he had fixed it up, made it work again, sprayed 3 coats of gray primer on this thing, and then he had painstakingly hand-painted He-Man symbols all over it. And then there was all the lettering that went with them. It had at least 15 of those He-Man symbols on it, more than the normal one was supposed to have. But the closer I looked, I think I've got a picture of it. Is there a picture? That's my version of it there. The closer I looked, as you might can tell, I don't know about my shorts. I just ignore though. My brother's face tells the story right there. I was still faking for Daddy's benefit right there. The closer I looked at that thing, the more I realized it would never fool anybody. That Christmas, I did not get what I wanted. But I got exactly what I needed. Because in that gift was the lavishness of my Father's love for me. Here was a man who worked himself nearly to death, raising a family, taking care of us. He did hard physical labor all day, every day. He came home exhausted, usually way after dark. And he somehow found the energy and the time to get in his shed and work for hours so that I could have that on Christmas Day. That has become one of the most special gifts I have ever received. Some gifts are like that, aren't they? The shepherd said, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has been made known to us, which the Lord has made known to us." The shepherds went with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph, and they found God's greatest gift lying in a manger. God in human flesh as a baby born into abject poverty. In that tiny, vulnerable child called Jesus, whose name means God saves God's people, in that baby is the fullness of God's love for the world. And yet I think it was not really what anybody wanted, was it? We wanted a God with a long white beard and flowing robes and thunder and lightning. We wanted that kind of a God with the voice of Morgan Freeman. We wanted that God. We wanted a God who could dramatically pluck us up out of the mess of life and set us on a pedestal where we might be safe from suffering and pain and struggle and the difficulties of life. We wanted a God with all the answers, who would bestow upon us an easy life full of riches and power. Instead, God comes to us as one of us, as a baby, choosing not to remove us from life, but to walk with us through life, holding our hearts in His heart, holding our hands in His hands, sharing our struggles, loving us through others and loving others through us, and growing with us into the people God created us to be. The hope of God's love and presence turned loose on the world. Here is God's gift, Jesus, Emmanuel. God is with us. It is exactly what we need. And by God's grace, it is becoming the only thing that we really want. Jesus, God with us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, may the people of God say, Amen.
The stars are brightly
If you will turn with me to page 12 in your hymnals as we prepare our hearts and minds for the sacrament of Holy Communion. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. This proves God's love towards us. Therefore, let us confess our sins before God and one another, if you will pray with me. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not heard. We have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love towards us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen.
I'd invite you to continue with us on the great Thanksgiving that is on the very next page. Some of what I say might be a little different as it is for Christmas Eve, but your responses will be the same, and you can follow along there on the next page, 13, I believe. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and good and a joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You created light out of darkness and brought forth life on the earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity and made covenant to be our sovereign God and spoke to us through your prophets. In the fullness of time, you gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. And at his birth, the angels sang, "Glory to you in the highest and peace to your people on earth." And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn, "Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. As Mary and Joseph went from Galilee to Bethlehem and there found no room, so Jesus went from Galilee to Jerusalem and was despised and rejected. As in the poverty of a stable, Jesus was born, so by the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. As your word became flesh, born of a woman on that night long ago, so on the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. And now, as the children of God, let us pray boldly that prayer that Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
We share together this juice and this bread tonight, and it is for us a meal of grace, a meal of God's presence and love that is offered to us in and through Jesus. I would invite those who are serving to come, that you may be served and then be prepared to serve the rest of us. Sally, and Summer will go down and serve them as I finish giving a few words of instruction. As they make their way, I just want to let you know we will be offering communion in two different ways. One, you may kneel here at the chancel rail and be served from these trays and take whatever time you need praying. And two, we will be serving by a method called intinction, which is where we tear a piece of bread and give it to you, and then you dip it in the juice. And then again, you might come and kneel at these at the chancel rail and take whatever time you need to pray. The intinction stations will be over here by this door and over there by that door. So if you'd like to receive in that method, then come down the outermost aisle and then make your way to the chancel rail to kneel. We will be coming as however you feel led. And so all of the aisles are open for you to come down as you feel comfortable and when it feels right to you. Just make sure we leave room for each other to return back to our seats after you've received communion together. I would ask that the choir, they're already doing it. Look, they're on it. I would invite the choir to come and be served first. And balcony folks, while the choir is being served, you're invited to come as well. And then those of you on the main floor will be invited to come as space allows for you to make it to the front. As we're receiving communion, we are going to be singing some familiar Christmas carols and hymns. So please just join right in. I think the choir does have a special that they're going to sing for us after we sing the first hymn. Know that you are invited in this place. Also know that if you'd like to make any offering tonight as a Christmas Eve communion offering, just place it here in this basket, and it will go to support our Martin Elementary School partnership. We've given, again, gift cards to all the teachers at Martin Elementary, and we continue to do our work of preparing backpacks with food for those who are hungry that go home every weekend for children who might not have enough to eat. And so we look forward to sharing in that together. This is not my table. This is not the Methodist table. It is the Lord's table, and it is open to all who would receive the grace of God that is offered in and through Jesus Christ. You are invited to come as you feel led.
Thank you.
If you happen to get through without a candle, there are plenty in the narthex if you need to slip out and get one. But I suspect that we all have our candles for singing Silent Night together. Remember, as we sing, it's best to tip the unlit candle to the lit candle. That seems to make things work better, and we don't set each other on fire. Let us pray together before we sing together, Silent Night. Let us pray. Oh God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Will you stand and let us sing together? Brothers and sisters, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit, you may live in hope now and forever. Merry Christmas. Amen.